वेलकम स्टूडेंट, यू नो टुडे द ऑनलाइन सेक्शन ऑफ सब्जेक्ट एडवांस मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेसेस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अनदर टू कंसेप्ट ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट। फर्स्ट कंसेप्ट इज इलेक्ट्रो हाइड्रोलिक फॉर्मिंग एंड सेकंड वन इज द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फॉर्मिंग और मैग्नेटिक पल्स फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेसेस। ओके, सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज दिस इलेक्ट्रो हाइड्रोलिक फॉर्मिंग। सो हियर इन दिस इलेक्ट्रो हाइड्रोलिक फॉर्मिंग वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द shock waves or energy from the waves which are created by the using the electricity and inside the hydraulic medium here. So here mostly we are going to use the transmission fluid or hydraulic fluid as a water here. Okay, so here a electromagnetic forming, it is a high energy rate forming process in which a shock waves to deform the work into a die cavity is generated by the discharge of electric energy between two electrodes. So here what is happening, here we are going to use the two electrodes and we are going to produce the shock waves by the discharge of electric energy between two electrodes which are submerged in a transmission fluid. Mostly the fluid is in the form of a water. Owing to its principle of operation, this process is called a electric discharge forming, where in this electric discharge forming we are going to use the shock waves which is created by this discharge of electric energy between two electrodes which are immersed in a transmission fluid which is mostly water. The setup for the process is illustrated in the figure. Here you can see, here you can see this is the diagram for this electro hydraulic forming. Here you can see these are the two electrodes here. These electrodes are connected with the power supply and the capacitor blank. These electrodes are immersed inside the transmission fluid. This transmission fluid is water here, and here between these two electrodes the spark is created which produces the shock waves, and because of the shock waves this workpiece which is placed above this cavity get demolded in itself inside this cavity here, and we get the desired shape of the workpiece. So here what is happening, when the spark between the two electrodes is created here, this workpiece collapses because of the striking of the shock waves. Because of this electric discharge, the shock waves deforms the workpiece into this cavity. Here this the space for the vacuum is provided so that the vacuum in the cavity is produced. What will happen if this vacuum line is not present there? If this vacuum line is not present there, then the air will get trapped inside this cavity, and this air will get heated up, maybe burned there, and can produce the forming defect. So to remove this air we are going to use the vacuum line here. Okay, here release to the electrodes. Electrohydraulic forming is similar to the explosive forming, but difference is that in explosive forming the shock waves created by the explosion, but here the shock waves are created by the electric discharge. The difference in the method of generation of the energy and the smallest amount of energy that are released, this limits electrohydraulic forming in much smaller part size. What we study is the disadvantage of this explosive forming, that it cannot be used for the small work or small size workpiece, but it electrohydraulic forming can be used for the small workpiece or can make in forming the smaller part size. Here you can see the can read this principle. A sudden electric discharge in form of spark is produced between the electrode, and the discharge produces the shock waves in the water medium. These shock waves are deformed in the workpiece and collapses into the die. The characteristics are very much similar to the explosive forming, except that a chemical explosive is replaced by a capacitor bank which stores energy here. Okay, we already discussed this point. here you can see this is the power supply capacitor and the voltage here. The capacitor is charged through a circuit. When a switch is closed, a spark is produced between the electrodes and shock waves or pressure pulse is created. The energy release is much lesser than the explosive forming. A typical setup of electromagnetic forming is as shown in the figure, where you can see this power supply is connected to the electrode here. These electrodes are immersed inside the transmitting medium, which is water here. And here on this die, there is a workpiece is placed, and when we put on this switch here, or when we start the switch, the electric discharge is produced inside this transfer medium and shock wave is get created, and this shock waves causes to deform the workpiece, and workpiece falls inside the cavity and takes the shape of this cavity. So here it is the working principle of this electrohydraulic forming. Here we can going to see this process characteristics. So its first process characteristic is that process standoff distance to be the optimum. The standoff distance, it is the distance between the workpiece and the electrodes, which produces the shock waves. Then energy of the pressure pulse depend on the size of the capacitor. Size of capacitor is also important parameter here. Then this water is generally used at the transmitting medium. The medium which we are going to use to transmit the shock waves is also plays important characteristic here. Then die cavity must be evacuated or vacuumed to prevent the adiabatic heating of the work due to the sudden compressing of the air. Then the material properties which regards the application of high rate of strain. Okay, now we are going to see the advantages of this electrohydraulic forming. Better control of pressure pulse as a source of energy is electrical. Then it is safer in handling than the explosive material. Then suitable for small to medium size workpieces. Then thin plates can be formed with smaller amount of energy. The disadvantages of this electrohydraulic forming is that the critical impact velocity of material is major concern. The critical impact velocity means the velocity of the shock waves which is going to collide with the workpiece. It is a cause to create some problem there. Then material with critical impact velocity less than 30 meter per second are not suitable. Then applications here, it can be used for the forming and tubular or dish shape. For this we can use this electrohydraulic machine forming there. Okay, then the impractical shapes can be made easily by using this electrohydro forming. Okay, so now we are going to see this electromagnetic forming. So first we read this, what is this electromagnetic forming? This electromagnetic forming, or it is also called as a magnetic pulse forming. It is a process in which sheet metal is deformed by a mechanical force of an electromagnetic field induced in the work part by energized coil. So here what we are going to use, we are going to use the coil which is energized and it creates a mechanical force due to the electromagnetic field, and using that mechanical force we are going to deform the sheet at we get the electromagnetic forming here. This coil is energized by the capacitor, produces a magnetic field. This generated eddy current in the work that produce their own magnetic field. The induced field opposes the primary field, producing a mechanical force that deforms the part into the surrounding cavity. Okay, so the important thing is that here by energizing the magnet coil here, it produces the eddy current and it produces its own magnetic field, producing the mechanical force that will help to deform the part or to deform the workpiece into the surrounding cavity. Then it is developed in 1960s. Electromagnetic forming, it is the most widely used HERF means high energy rate forming processes. It is typically used to form tubular parts as illustrated in the figure. Okay, here you can see this is the coil here. This coil is placed inside this tube here, and this is the die. This is the cavity here, and when you energize this coil by connecting it to the capacitor or power source, then this coil produces the magnetic field, and because of the production of this magnetic field, eddy currents are also produces, and this produces the mechanical force, and because of this mechanical force, this tube get force inside this cavity, and we get the final product like this here. So you can see this is the final product. Because of the energizing of the coil, this tube get pushed inside this cavity by production of the mechanical force, and we get this final product like this here. Okay, now here we are going to see this again, this electromagnetic forming or magnetic pulse forming process. This process is based on the fundamental principle of electrical technology, i.e. when a current flows in a conductor, a magnetic field is set up around it. If the current and hence the magnetic field changes, a current is induced in any other conductor produces in the magnetic field. Okay, so here we are going to see the process. The electrical energy is stored inside the capacitor bank and the tubular workpiece is mounted on the mandrel having die cavity to produce the shape. Here you can see this is the mandrel, and on this mandrel we place this tube here, and inside this tube we keep the coil here, which is electromagnetic coil. Okay. A primary coil is placed around the tube. When the switch is closed, the energy is discharged through the coil. This coil is produced a very high magnetic field around it. Listen, student, here is the diagram is different. Here the diagram is different as I show you before this. Here what is happening, here we place this coil inside this tube, but here in this book they keeps the coil outside the tube, but the function is same, but only difference is that here we put this coil inside this tube, and here we put this coil outside the tube. So here what will happening, this tube will get contract or will comes to each other, and here, and in that previous image the tube will get move away. In a tube, a secondary current is induced which creates its own magnetic field in the opposite direction. Direction of these two magnetic field opposes one another, and hence rigidly held coil ripples the workpiece into the die cavity. Work tube collapses into the die, assuming its and taking its shape here. Then the process parameters. The process parameters is workpiece size, then electrical conductivity of work material, then the size of capacitor bank and insulation on coil, then strength of current which decides the strength of magnetic field and force applied. Then here are the we list down this advantages of this electromagnetic forming. It is suitable for a small tube. Then the next advantage is operations like collapsing, bending, crimping can be easily done. then the electric energy applied can be precisely controlled and hence process is accurately controlled. This process is completely safe here. As we are not going to use any explosive material here, so this process is completely safe. Then here we are going to see the disadvantages of this electromagnetic forming or magnetic pulse forming process. It's applicable for electrically conductive material only, non-suitable for large work pieces. Then rigid clamping of coil is major concern in case of this electromagnetic forming. Life of coil is also to be considered here. Then the application of this electromagnetic forming or electro discharge forming is that it is used in crimping of the coil tubes and wires, then bending of tubes in a complex shape, then bulging of thin tubes. Here we are use this electromagnetic forming processes. In the next section we will see this high velocity forming processes, which are petroforge hammers, then dynaspace, then cleaning hammers. These are the capacities and classification, and we will see this high energy rate forming processes in the next section. Here you can see this is the small video of this electro hydraulic forming processes. Here you can see this is the capacitor bank, this is the power rectifier unit, this is the water, and these are the electrodes. And when the electric discharge is created by between these electrodes here, the electric shock waves will get created. We already see this point, this major difference between electro hydraulic forming and explosive forming is that here we are not going to use the explosives, here we are going to use the capacitor bank. Okay, so here you can see this animation here of this electro hydraulic forming process. You can see here what is happening. These are the two electrodes and this is connected to the capacitor or power source here, and when this electrode, this switch is on, between these electrodes the shock waves it gets produced, and when this shock waves it collides with this workpiece falls inside this die cavity and gets and attain the shape of the cavity here. These are the kind of application, or this is the final products which we can obtain by using this electro hydraulic forming. Then this is the electromagnetic forming. Here we wind this coil around this tube, and when we energize this tube, this mechanical force is created which pushes this tube away from this coil, and we get this final size of this workpiece like this. So here you can see this is the tube, this is the cavity, and this is the workpiece which is placed around it, and these are the electric coil. When this coil produces the magnetic field, then this tube tries to move away from this magnetic field and get collapsed into this cavity here, and we get this final product like this. Okay. This is the another diagram. When we put this energized coil inside this tube, and then tubes again tries to move away from the coil, and it will attain the final shape like this. So here when we put this tube on this coil, then this tube will get the shape, or it will move away from this coil. We can see here. This is the electromagnetic forming process. Because of production of this electromagnetic field, this workpiece try to move away from this magnetic field and it will attain the shape of this cavity here. So here you can see. See the final shape. So okay, here we are stopping our today's section. See you soon on the next section. Thank you.